So it's good, we think, that people are in contact with each other and talk about it to get a solution for this. So we want to avoid this, of course. So I suggest when everybody is leaving this building to disinfect your hands. There are some bottles on the table still everywhere, because probably you have heard a lot of good stuff. You run into the greenhouse, but better think one more time before you're just running in the greenhouse and disinfect hands and feet. Later I come back on this picture with some practical things. We are a supplier of a lot of products, but we want to try to make the hygiene subject, we try to make it visual. Normally we talk about a product or about a machine, but hygiene is more than that. It's a combination of everything, actually. You have to combine the machines with the products, etc. So what we can do? For the hygiene, we can talk about water quality. There are a lot of different things. I don't go too much in detail for today, but we can always do this on location on your site. Persons are also a big factor in hygiene. Persons, visitors, those are quite easy because they follow you nice, they put on some disposables, and that's it. But your employees, they are working all day in the greenhouse, making wounds, cutting fruits or leaves. So those you have to take care of. The equipment also goes up and down in the greenhouse. So this is also something you have to be aware of. And the last one, the seeds and the propagators, we cannot do something about that. Just make sure you are critical to your suppliers for that. So we try to make it even more visual than the previous slide. In the top, you see the applications, so disinfection nets, hygiene locks, foam application stuff. Linked to that, you have products. And there is also relations between the suppliers you have for the applications and to the products. So it has to be working together. So cleaning and disinfection products. And the middle part, the knowledge, you can, like the meetings like this, like today, but also like we have with the research stations, we had to do some research previous with the CGMV, now with the TBRFV. We want to test our product if it's working or not. We want to be sure about it. So we have contact with the research stations in Holland, but also the knowledge center and the webshop. Growers easily can look for some practical tips on hygiene, on whatever, on the webshop, just to bring everyone together. This is an example of the virus. So it's now updated, of course, but there is just practical tips, and I think that's what growers need. Easily to reach and points to do. When we visiting companies, because they have a hygiene question, it's not that big, but in the top you see the expectations. Your retailers buying your product, they can have expectations, like the product should be clean, should be safe, etc. But there are also risks. Some growers higher risks, for example, breeding companies, they have a top of the bill. They need everything, they need to do everything for the hygiene. Tomato growers have risks, pepper growers have risks, and other crops have less risks. So also less to do for hygiene. But I think the important thing in the middle, the practical thinking, and that's what we try to help you with, to do practical thinking to solve the problems on each company, because each company works different. Each person has a different workflow. Now, here you see a normal setup of a company, and we make some one person, or maybe two or three, depends on the size of the company, we make one person responsible for hygiene, because there is a lot to do in a horticulture company. There is problems with water, there is the sales are going good or bad, electricity you have to change. So hygiene is always put below. And now we try to level it up to reduce the risk and to get a more stable production, actually. So external, the EPO, you see it, some knowledge partners, some research stations, that's the knowledge, actually. And then you see the green one, the door. There you can do something, because that's your company. You can decide who I want to enter, what kind of material I let in my company and whatnot. And in the greenhouse, that is actually the most of the time the most difficult part, because in the greenhouse, everything is moving all day around, but you want to do something. But you guess the question is what you can do, and that depends also on the risk we talked about before. So, external example, from plant protection products, we all do tests about spraying equipment, etc. So we also do it with foam for the disinfection. We talk with the guys who make the techniques, we talk with the producer of some disinfectants, but we also talk with the research stations, like, hey, what do you think is the best way to apply, and try to find some theoretically reasons behind it, of course. So this is, before I worked for a seed company, this is GSPPP, so all seeds, not all, but all tomato seeds should be produced by GSPPP. This we try to make work for just normal production locations as well. And that's possible, you know, you have a company. For example, the yellow part, it's your company, it's your totally company. The round is a big fence, one gate, the red lock. There you can decide, what do I let in, what I won't. Then you have, in general, there are more compartments of greenhouses. So you can decide what you want to go into greenhouse. But also in between greenhouses, you see often traffic. You know, and you have to be sure there's not cross-contamination between people or carts. Or so we had a nice example of a GSPP, and then we see this. You know, it's on the terrain of the grower. Yeah, I said, I ordered a container which is leaking free. But the containers were out of order, so I just get this one. And he said, it's okay, you know. But actually, we try to avoid all the risk, and then there's a container with plant juice. We heard it's long of its persistence, so it will stay a long time in the concrete. It will stay a long time in your car mats from the car. And it's also mechanical transmitted. So you walk through, you go to your company, and then there is a chance that you have the virus with you. So that's an easy thing. Cleaning is important. So we always ask of people in general, disinfect your hands, change your shoes, etc. This is even this is in Mexico. So with you have high class, like you will see some pictures, but even with low level or with low cost, actually, you can do something on hygiene. Just let the people wash their hands with the product, which also disinfecting soap. But also give the possibilities that they, again, that the one person is responsible, and you know, give the people the knowledge why they should disinfect, and also tell them about the risk, what's happening if they don't do it. Like this is more the high tech then. People are forced to wash in this case. In general, when we ask people go left, they go right. So we try to make a setup in general for the companies where which we helping with the hygiene that is HUFTA proof. So people, you have to manage them to do what you want them to do. So here the people are forced to wash. If they don't do, they cannot enter. Of course, you can go underneath it, but I think one time and then you can go out of the company. This is also like people getting soap on their hands. The soap is sticky, so they don't do it, and it's gone. Then they wash their hands and with the sensors, and then the toilets, etc. And then they go into the greeners and the back, the tomatoes you see, so to disinfect the feet and the hands. So there are different solutions. Question for the group, but maybe that's difficult with all those people, but disposables, before or after a hygiene station? Think. A lot of people do it before, but you can assume those new boots, they are clean, you know, they are just from the fabric. Also, you can assume, or we know, those boots are not standing that long. So in general, the shoe are breaking, the gloves are breaking. So better, first disinfect your shoes, and disinfect your hands, and then put on the gloves or the booties. Overall you can do, but the both things, if the shoe is breaking, you know the dirt, because the brushes are rotating, the dirt is there, a leaf. And the disinfectant is also spread on it, so your shoe is also covered with some disinfectant. So it's also a mindset, like how do you do the steps? And we visit a lot of companies worldwide, and often we hear, yeah, we do it all for 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. But sometimes it's a good time to change. So this is a Spain breeding company. You know, every country has its own facilities. But the idea is here to create a long contact time. You can put a mat or a bot or whatever for your feet, 1 second and continue. But you also can make sure the people changing their, putting on the overall and the booties on the mat, washing the hands on the mat, so you have a long contact time. And that's what we see, maybe in the next slide. No. But you see contact time and concentration is always related, you know. That will come later on. But also with the entries, we are still with the doors, so we are still just not into the greenhouse. What is entering the greenhouse? A lot of people, companies, they have a food bot for the people. But the forklift or the tractor or whatever just goes out on the back door. So we invest maybe 10,000 euros here, and in the back, the people just entering. Also the forklift driver just, you know, he jumps off the truck, jump on the truck again, drives over the mat, and then he jumps in the greenhouse. So think about that. So we are in the greenhouse, but in general, measuring is important. You add a detergent or a disinfectant, and then it's the question, how long it's active? Is it still active after 5 people or 10 people? Is it active after 1 day? And that's often something also people have to know, and that's the hygiene manager should do. Check every food bot, every disinfection mat. Are the stations doing what we think they are doing? Adding the amount of disinfectant on the hands, for example. Measuring is really important. So, it's a pity. The circle, actually, the picture there with the trolley, it's a greenhouse where they have a crop rotation. And that's also the point. Even after the crop rotation, make sure everything is coming in is disinfected. Not like, okay, you know, we take out the crop, everywhere plant juice, then we clean, and then we disinfect, new plastic, new slabs, etc., and then it's okay. No, constantly you have to do something. Also, the carts, clean them frequently. Like, I also come from a horticulture company. We grow cucumbers and tomatoes. We cleaned one time a year, we cleaned everything. But now, with the virus, and you see a lot of people at these meetings, they say, yeah, maybe we should clean the machines once a month, or every week, or 4 times a year. You know, how less buildup of dirt load, how more easy your disinfection will be. Knife disinfection, a lot of people ask it. There are different ways you can work, and that's what I say. Every company has their own way of working, and then we try to apply something that's working and effective. But also the phones. I guess everyone here has one or two or three phones. They all go into the greenhouse. But also we shake hands, we eat a tomato maybe here on the salad today, and we swipe it on the phone. Nah. The most products people use are kind of oxidating, you know, they are corrosive. So your phone is not that happy with it. Like put it in a zip bag. Just easy solution. And this is what happened in some breeding stations in Holland. So, the first picture you saw, 2 rows were probably infected with the virus. So the way of working is always important. Always do like the Peppino protocol, work on the same way. But you can do that for your people, like, yeah, everyone is working from left to right. But in the evening, somebody came in and he has to spray the whole greenhouse. It's 6 o'clock and you think fast, start in the beginning and goes from left to right. So then, you do everything you think. You know, you think you do everything, but just a spraying robot does something opposite. And also, there are some ideas about the disinfecting knife after a row, after a plant. Now, after a plant, in general, people like to hear that, but it's not so efficient, they see then. So then they get 5 plants, but then what's the effect? So then we see we do 1 knife a row. We do like a dirty bucket and a clean bucket with clean knives, and then you change it. And also put a disinfectant in those buckets for all day or for all night. Now, gloves. To change gloves, it's the most easy way to do. Even then, we also sell gloves, of course, and there are also different qualities. Now, in general, people want the cheapest quality, so the people working in those rows, and after five plants, the gloves are breaking. So what's the effect of a glove then? So also think about that. In tomato, a lot of people, they're using, what you call it? It's kind of sock, something on the arm to protect the arms, otherwise they get really, really green. They wear this, in general, they wear this the whole year. So maybe you have company clothes, maybe not, but maybe you think about it, like people change the clothes daily. And this thing is year-round in the greenhouse. You know, the green layer getting thicker, 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 thicker. So also think about those things. And that's the, not the problem, but that's the mistake often in general. Like, hygiene goes about not about the product, not about time, not about concentration alone. It's the whole package. So, as I say, we think crop is finished, the year was good or bad. I cannot decide that for here in the UK, but we take out the crop, plant juice everywhere, and then. So try, some people already don't chop it anymore, but they just hop it, take it out. But try to avoid that the plant juice is spread in the whole greenhouse, or that the parts of the plant are in your screens. All what you don't make it, what you don't make dirty, what you don't have to clean. So that's the thing, actually. And that's where we are here, like removing material, logic, you should say. But we see a lot of stories like people just walk over with some spraying equipment where the tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers, whatever is still laying. Killing algae. Algae also contain a lot of possibilities to attract the dirt and the pathogens, virus as well. And why cleaning? When we say it, everyone says, yeah, logic. You know, you clean before you disinfect. But in practice, a lot of years it's not done. So more and more people are now aware, like, hey, we have to clean the gutters, or we have to clean the carts and then disinfect. So that's always the trick. First, you remove the dirt, but also you dilute, if there is a virus, you dilute it. And when the dilution is lower, the effect of your, if the reaction with the disinfectant can be better, so you can have a more effective disinfection. We do that in the greenhouse, but also canteens, toilet rooms, etc. Think about light switch, everything. So foam, we did some research for the virus with some products, and we see the foam really makes the time it's needed to kill a virus lowers a lot. You know, the foam, it's logical. Foam, nice picture, automatically. That one. Foam cover all the cracks. Vertical stays much longer. Even if you have wires or pipes, the foam goes around it. And if you spray, in general, it just goes one side and then it evaporates. People see what they do. So in general, when you use foam, you should use less product because you have air with product. But because people see what they do, getting more critical, like they spray the, oh, I missed, one more time. And that's what you want. You want that people who you ask to disinfect the greenhouse, that they do the whole greenhouse and not 95% of it. So a lot of different types of foaming, of course, different crops. So you see the exposure time of the contact time is also in relation with concentration. We see that with before we had the research done on the TOBRV, we had to compare it with CGMV, and that is already known because that's 5 to 10 years ago for the cucumber growers. But we saw that the 4% is doing its job. And why? A virus contains RNA covered by protein layers. And in general, plant pathogens are more tough than animal or human pathogens. You know, the plant pathogens have to survive a winter or summer, or that kind of things. So spore of fungi make spores, and the viruses are more tough to take off because of a thicker protein layer. So You can have oxidation, or you can have, with the benzoic acid, then it's soaking through and change the pH level of the RNA that has a pH to change, and then it can eliminate the virus. So be critical. You know, I heard 1 million euro for a hectare of greenhouse. Be critical of what you use to disinfect. It's a pity if it doesn't look nice, but it also gets rough, attract more dirt, so pathogens can stay more easy in those rough surfaces. Now we do the whole hygiene, we do also water treatments, but be aware, like a lot of disinfection units like UV or heat are placed, and then maybe it's checked by insulation, but after a couple of years, it's really good to check it again. Check your silos, like what's in there. So really, you have to take the whole package from door in the ground, the pipes, till the plant. These are a lot of points. Bumblebees, everyone is talking about it, but your employees, they are working on the plants. They are making even more ones daily, every plant they touch. The viruses in the fruit, so if you transport boxes from company A to B, be aware of that. Yeah, a lot of things. And I think the last one is more nice. Here you see some MyPacks, so the ground covers for taking off the plants. Those are in general quite dirty. Seeds are in it, juice are in it, everything is in it. Be aware of that, that's first, that you have to deal to talk to your contractor, what she's doing. But we just be aware, we try to clean them and with foam, etc. It is possible, but you have to focus on that. And not just like in 2 seconds we can do the whole roll. It really takes time to clean this kind of carpets. Thank you for the attention.